Hello everyone, I am Panos Vasiliadis and I am presenting to you the results of a joint effort with Kostas Dimolikas and Apostolos Zaras on the problem of studying schema evolution and specifically on studying how the structure of the foreign keys to which a table is related affects the table's behavior during its subsequent evolution. And basically the method that we have used is that we study the histories of six relational schemata from free open source projects with significant durations and characteristics. And we have extracted out of these histories the births and the deaths of the tables, the intra-table updates, which means attribute additions, deletions, data type changes, primary key changes, and the foreign keys and their changes. And we model each of the versions of the history of the schema that we have extracted as a graph. So the tables are nodes and the foreign keys are directed edges. And you can see on the slide some of these graphs. So in fact, every version of every schema's history is a graph. And if you take the union of all the nodes and all the edges of the different versions of a schema's history, you produce the diachronic graph of the schema's history, which we use for subsequent analysis, as I will explain later. And then we relate the topology of a table, which is the position of the respective node in the graph. We relate this to the evolutionary characteristics, and specifically, first, to when the table is born, which is important, as we will see, and second, to how many changes the table has undergone through its life. And what we did is that we have defined four fundamental topological categories for the tables of a schema, depending on the structure of the edges around the node. So if the table the table's node has no inciting edges, 0 degree, we call it isolated. If it is a fountain node with only outgoing edges, we call it source. If it has only incoming edges, it's a sink, we call it lookup, and the rest of the tables, which are very few actually, having both incoming and outgoing edges, we call them internal. And we have crunched our numbers around two questions, as I already said. The first one has to do with when tables are being born, and specifically, whether a table is born in the originating version of the schema history, which we call V0, or not. And in the numbers that you see, whenever you see a red number is a high percentage, whenever you see blue numbers is a small percentage, we just discriminate between the originating version and all the rest. And as you can see, isolated and source tables, they don't have too many red numbers in the category born in the originating version. So it is easier to add this category of tables later in the life of the schema. Whereas on the right-hand side, lookup and internal tables, they are full of red color, which means that the largest percent, and in fact, in many cases, all of the tables of this category were born in the originating version, which means that no such tables were added later. A second research question had to do with whether the topology of a table relates to its intra-table update activity. And again, we have the four topological categories are isolated, source, lookup, and internal, and the tables are split into rigid, which means zero changes whatsoever, quiet, which means few changes, and active, which means lots of changes. All the technical specifications are in the paper. And again, when you see red color, it means a high percentage, and when you see a blue color, it means a small percentage in this particular category. And so progressively, as you move from isolated on the left towards the internal on the right, you will see that the red numbers start to move from the rigid category towards the quiet and eventually towards the active, which means that isolated tables are mostly rigid, and then progressively you have more and more quiet tables with few changes, and in the end you have more active tables with lots of changes. And this brings us to the fundamental contribution of the paper, which is if you put all this together, you have a spectrum of increasing complexity. So there is a correlation between the topology of tables and how active they are in terms of their evolution. So on the left-hand side of the spectrum, you have isolated tables. They are almost rigid with zero changes, and they are frequently born after the originating version. And similar to them are the source tables. They're a little bit more active, but overall, these two categories, they constitute the mega category of most populous, less active, and easier to add tables. And on the other side, you have, on the right-hand side, you have the internal tables at the furthest right, which are the fewest of all. They are the most active of all. And they are mostly born at the first version of the schema, which means they are not born later. Similar to them, a little bit less active are the lookup tables. And so overall, this last mega category is less populous, more active, and harder to add as schema ages. And we attribute this behavior to a phenomenon that in previous papers we have christened as gravitation to rigidity. And this means that as the schema ages and the code is built on top of the schema, the developers are disinclined to add more complexity to the structure of the schema. On the contrary, they prefer to add simpler topologies, simpler structures, like the ones on the left-hand side. And if they need to work with the complex structures, they do it mostly via attribute injection. And we refer you to the paper for more details about that and what the implications are for us as researchers and teachers. Summarizing, first I would like to take the opportunity to thank the organizer of this year's ER for all their efforts. And second, I would like to ask you to visit our Schema Biographies website, where you can find all our previous research as well as everything about this paper, including links to the code and the data, and more details and videos and presentations. And with this, I thank you all for your attention, and I am here for questions.